Hello everybody and welcome to the channel again. It's been a while since my last update and things have been happening in life that have been keeping me away from the PC and from making videos and whatever. This one's just a bit of an update on a major breakthrough that's come about over the last couple of weeks while working with AMD on the AMD reset bug. Now this demonstration is going to show off the reset feature working now on the Vega 10 series, which is the Vega 56 and 64. We have preliminary support for Vega 12, which is the Founders Edition, I believe, and the Pro workstation cards. The Vega 12, Vega 20, which is Radeon 7, and the Navi cores at the moment are not supported. I don't have these cards on hand yet, so I'm unable to actually write and test the code for them. So what we've got here is a second PC over on the right. It's got a AMD Vega 56 in it, and it's configured to boot off it. It's going to post that card and everything. The monitor you're seeing here is off that machine. The reason why I'm not using the monitor behind it is because I discovered that OSX will not, it doesn't like the monitor. It won't post the GPU on the monitor properly. So I'm just using another one I've got that's just handy. On the left, I'm going to use the PC here to SSH into the machine in order to basically control it because it's got no keyboard and mouse on it and I haven't configured EvDev. I really don't care to because this is just a development system to get this reset working. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is turn the machine on. And you can see here that Debian started to load. Now, I apologize for the poor video quality. I don't have a proper film camera. I believe I'm getting one from Level One. Wendell's very kind and I believe he's arranging one for me. But at the moment I don't have that, so I'll just do the best I can with this. Okay, and this is on a 5.0 kernel. Now you can see here that we've started up into X on the login screen. This is running LightDM. I'm not going to log this in because what we're going to do is just go and launch our VM and take over the video card. Now I've SSH'd into the other machine and I've got a little script here I'm about to use to launch the virtual machine. So what this is going to do is unbind the AMD GPU driver after stopping X. It will then use the reset program to reset the card and then bind it to VFIO PCI and then start QEMU. And as you can see here, it's starting to boot the virtual machine now. Now I'm going to use VNC on the other machine to control Clover and to start the system booting because it's not configured to auto boot. This is just using VNC, so nothing special. Now what you can see here, the OSX system is starting to boot. It takes a little bit for it to happen, but eventually we'll see the window, the OSX loading screen with the Apple logo and everything. There you go, there's OSX running on a reset Vega. So to reiterate, the order of operation was we posted the system, the physical system on the Vega, we let X start, we stopped X, we unbound the video card, we reset the video card and then bound it to VFIO PCI, then we started the virtual machine up, which now has control of the card. So if we now log this in, let's see, a few shameless plugs load up here in a second. Now we can move things around. You'll see the display is clearly working. We've got accelerated graphics. This is also running Mojave. I'm not a Mac person, so I'm sort of a bit lost here, but you can see it's functional. It's hard to see it, but on the About screen there, it actually is showing that we're running the Vega 56 with 8 gig of RAM and so on. So to finish up, what we'll do is we'll shut down the system to show that it shuts down successfully, resets, and returns us to LightDM. And there you go, we're back at X. So now the GPU is being reset twice. What we're going to do is do it one more time, but this time instead of shutting down OSX cleanly, we're going to do a dirty shutdown and just terminate the virtual machine. This will leave the, or normally leaves the Vega 10 in a dirty state, but the script I've got set up here will reset the card as soon as it terminates and restart LightDM. Oops, almost forgot to start the system booting again. I got to jump into VNC again. Now, the goal here is to simulate a hard crash of the virtual machine or a termination of the virtual machine to show that we can recover from a bad system or a crashed VM. Now, what I'm going to do is jump into the QMU console and terminate the VM so it doesn't get a chance to shut down. This will, like I said, simulate a crash of the VM. And if you notice there, it recovered before I could even tell you what was happening. So we can reset the card rapidly and regain control of it. So it's now running again on the host system's bare metal. There's an interesting possibility with this now is that you could run a virtualized Macintosh or Hackintosh, if you may, on any hardware basically that supports pass-through, instead of needing very specific hardware, even if you've only got one GPU, you just have to run the host system headless. Now, I'd like to thank those so far that have been supporting this project and the work I've been doing, not just Looking Glass, but the stuff here on the kernel and on the AMD range of products. Unfortunately, I don't actually receive sponsorship from AMD for any of this. This is all done in my own time and using my own equipment or equipment that's been kindly donated either through Level 1 Tech. Wendell over there has been supporting me as best he can and the community in general as well. But if we want to get support working on other cards, unless AMD are willing to step up to the plate and send me some hardware, I need to call on you guys again in order to get the support in here for Vega 20, which is the Radeon 7, and Navi, which is the RX 5800, I believe it is. I've set up a GoFundMe for the Radeon 5800, but the Vega 20 I haven't because it's not such a common card. One member already on the forums, Starlord, has offered to loan me his card in order to do this. In order to add this support and get it all working and functional. So thank you to him. Just so that people are aware too, the work I'm doing here is all voluntary. I don't get paid for this. People are kind enough to donate and support, and those that do, thank you already. If you're not already and would like to support me, I'll put some links down below, both to Patreon and Ko-fi, as well as to PayPal, if you'd like to sponsor this work to continue.